Hi, I'm Spencer Aronfeld, and welcome to the latest edition of Life of a Trial Lawyer. Tonight I find myself on a relatively quiet street in downtown Lima, Peru, or an area that's called Mila Flores. This is the third time I've been to Peru this year in the representation of a man who's from Peru, who was living in Miami, and who's the victim of a medical malpractice case. His deposition was taken today, at least part of it was, because after about 8 hours, his deposition was not complete. And it got me to thinking this evening about the cost of justice, particularly in Florida when it comes to medical malpractice cases. In Florida, if somebody believes they're the victim of medical malpractice, within 2 years of the date of the alleged malpractice, they have to find expert witnesses in the exact specialty of those doctors. So if it's a cardiologist, it's got to be a heart doctor. If it's a urologist, it has to be a urologist that's going to testify that those particular defendants made a medical mistake. That's very expensive and very difficult to do and requires a lot of medical records and a lot of expense, and then depositions and interrogatories and court costs, and it just goes on and on. And God forbid your client, like ours, gets deported in the middle of the process, which happens often in Miami because most of our clients are living there perhaps not under legal conditions. If they're deported, then the expense in the case becomes all that more difficult for them. And while lawyers' fees mount and costs increase and delay after delay happens, as today, for instance, where the deposition wasn't completed, in the end, after all these costs, Florida's got caps on damages that say no matter how much a jury might particularly think the damages to a particular injured patient are, there are limitations. Currently, the limitation is $250,000 if the doctor, for non-economic or pain and suffering damages, which is regardless of what a jury thinks, what the current law in Florida is. So, at the end of this day and at the end of this journey, I've been here now for several days, it's got me thinking that there has to be another solution to how we treat injured patients and their claims and get them justice, particularly in Florida. There has got to be a less expensive means of doing this. I propose that before lawsuits can be filed, there needs to be some kind of mediation that is mandatory, where both parties can sit down and try to resolve their claims before the costs become astronomical. And in the end, regardless of how much it costs, there's going to be limitations in most cases on damages. My opinion, as a Florida trial lawyer, I appreciate you listening to this. Take a look at Lima tonight. It's a typical night here in downtown Lima.